Snowflake mentality is one that resorts to trigger warnings, safe spaces, things of that nature that we don't necessarily believe in. We believe in freedom of thought, and we believe that you should be able to voice your opinion without being shut down by the other side, like we've seen at campuses such as Missouri and Yale.
Even if it's problematic?
Problematic. How?
Causing harm, violence to marginalized identities.
So non-white, that's what that means.
Well, I don't know.
Well, not just non-white.
No,
but
I'm going to let you talk because this is y'all's space. And so.
No, we're allowed to have free flowing debate.
Exactly. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like,
okay.
Even if it causes harm or violence to a marginalized identity, you guys should be able to speak and not.
Absolutely not. If there's violence or harm caused directly by us, if there's anything like that, that's fine. But if words hurt you, then that's something different entirely. You're allowed to
derogatory words are not supposed to hurt.
Define derogatory words.
Well, there was a post. I'm pretty sure y'all meant not facts. But another word about what was going to happen on West Coast Beach in response to what happened to my guest. So, like, that right there, that's a word that's very derogatory in society overall, not just specific to people with marginalized identities. Most people don't say that in public, and they can't say it at their job or they lose it. And so what I'm asking, do you think you should be able to say that word in class and that not cause harm or violence? So you guys don't know what y'all post that everyone looking at?
Can you specify which word you're talking about?
There is a post.
Facts
is what the word was supposed to be meant, but
okay.
No, it was meant to be facts.
Okay.
Yeah.
What does that mean?
Facts don't care about your feelings. For example, there is a higher murder rate amongst transgender individuals. However, there is no statistical evidence that that is done by black police or by by police officers, and they're not. There isn't some bad.
No, it's
conspiracy.
Done by their friends,
done
their family,
by
and their lovers.
And that's
what are you talking about?
No
one's saying
like
it's done by police.
We're saying that it's done
by
anyone.
Because
it's not appropriate.
No, and don't get me wrong. I watched both of your Facebook Live.
No, yeah.
Anyone who harasses someone because of how they feel, absolutely that's.
Oh, it's not a. It's identified, not a feeling. Let's get that clear.
Also, and you talked about black and you talked about police, so that might need to be inserted here too. Do you guys don't think statistically the black community is targeted by the police and die at a higher rate? Because that is statistically proven with research.
Okay.
I'm a researcher, just so you know. So I, like, literally, that's informed knowledge, not opinion either.
Okay, I don't lay my opinions out either because I know how sensitive.
You just said you wanted opinions to be able to be said without shutting down, and them are opinions because most of the time this is rooted in opinion unless you're going off informed knowledge.
Yes, and my informed. I look at FBI studies. I look at Department of Justice things because I know obviously we can see how contentious these kind of issues are.
Contentious.
Well, we're talking right now, and you know there's
critical
issues.
Dialogue is important
yes,
in all
absolutely.
This. In all this. So I'm gonna let you continue, and I cut you off, and I apologize, but I still don't know what like reality means or what is that called?
Mentality. The idea that you can hide and retreat to safe spaces or trigger warning.
That's what that is. Okay.
Yes.
So you think people are wanting to go safe spaces because of comfort and not humanity and survival and being able to function in white systems? You know, KU is a white system, that it was designed for white students. And it systematically disenfranchises marginalized identities, right? And even they themselves acknowledge that. We have institutional racism that exists here. We have barriers that marginalized people face that white individuals don't. The university themselves says that. So surely you acknowledge that since you look at statistics.
No, I don't see any institutional racism here. There are absolutely individual racist acts.
So what statistics are you looking at? They're telling you that there's no racism.
I didn't say that there's no racism at KU.
Institutional racism. So you don't think there's any systematic racism at KU?
I can't find any violence.
Because racism is attached to oppression and systematic. What you're talking about individually, that's discrimination. Words are important.
Discrimination, racism, I don't.
There are two different things. One is systematically reinforced, and one is done at an individual level. So if you look at me and call me a nigger, that is discrimination. Now, if the university creates barriers that don't let me achieve the same outcomes of my white counterparts, that's institutional racism.
Can you lay out those barriers for me?
When I come from a high school that didn't have access to AP classes, meaning I didn't have the same access or quality to education that my white counterparts did, then I'm expected to arrive on campus and compete at the same collegiate level when my family has not amassed enough wealth since they came out of chattel slavery to literally pay for my education, so I go into debt and I graduate with a huge amount of debt when my white counterparts do not.
To live in a hall that I feel comfortable in, and I still got shit for it.
That shows that there are problems with this campus, that there are problems with how this campus is run.
There are problems with individuals.
No, there are problems with how this campus is run. There are not problems with
individuals.
When
we talk about individuals who have power at campus, that's an institutional level. That's not an individual level because they have authority over those people and they get to decide whether Kate lives somewhere that they're comfortable.
Why do you not like safe spaces? I just want an answer as to why you want safe spaces to no longer be present on campus.
I do not want safe spaces to be present on campus anymore because I truly believe that they're a way for people to hide from the
But that's not your decision to make.
Okay.
Those places were made for people like me, people like Trinity, people like Blake.
And for people like you if you ever need a safe space.
This is really important.
Go ahead.
Really important.
Go ahead.
No, it's fine. I think...
Go ahead.
I think you guys are a bit confused. I'm talking about safe spaces. Are you guys talking about the signs that professors
No.
have?
Safe spaces. The center. So,
column A. The only places that we're given here.
We are speaking.
We don't feel safe
anywhere else.
I don't study in the library.
No.
Because I don't feel comfortable with people always wondering what my gender identity is and how I express myself. And I don't feel comfortable being in classrooms where I'm supposed to speak as a trans human and as a queer person, as all queer people. That shows you that there's a problem with this institution, that they are not being, that these students are not being taught that they are supposed to create safe spaces.
Pardon me, but why do you care what other people think?
Because you're trying to get rid
of
it. If I don't care about that,
then I get murdered.
Safe spaces are a necessity. It's not a question. It's not for you to say. It's not for anyone else to say. Safe spaces are necessary because the institution that we're at is not a safe space in its entirety. So we have to carve out places like the OMA and the Silk Office, which we shouldn't have to do. We have to carve out places and fight for places that we feel safe, because not only will we get harassed, we'll be murdered, we'll be all this stuff discriminated against, because we have to do that. It's not because we want to.
Feeling safe is different than caring about what people think.
We don't care what people think.
My pronouns are they.
They.
So from now on, when you refer to them, use they, them, there, because we've shown you the respect to refer to you by your name. So from now on, you will refer to them as they, because that is the appropriate thing to do when you are above the age of fucking 12.
To know that the research that you say that you also believe in, if you control for things like gender identity, race, and all that, that explains why there's disparities between white students and others. Because our experience is so drastically different than yours that we do not make it to the finish line. The key to graduating at a university is having a sense of belonging and community. So if you go to a campus and ostracize every day without y'all existing and cannot function, how do you think we can have a group that is pushing the agenda? You don't even deserve to be here and feel safe. Are we supposed to get to a finish line?
Like, that's what I'm saying.
I don't want safety for all students. But you put in an application to demonstrate on WESCO and cut up safe space stickers.
How are people supposed to be safe outside of safe spaces when the campus itself is not safe?
I'm talking about physically being safe.
Look at the phone.
You have an iPhone, right?
Civilization is something white folks invented as well, and I do not apply to whiteness.
White, literally civilized
motherfucking nation.
Man, I'm not even going to attack you for your lack of knowledge. Civilization was created. You inserted yourself into other people's land and forced your culture upon them. That is what equates to civilization. I do not function in white singularity. Acculturation? You're still reaping the benefits of it, are you not? Are you still reaping the benefits of it? Is there not legacy that was created from slavery?
Are you not currently benefiting?
What legacy? Oh, well, imagine your wealth off of slavery. You don't think that exists? And you still have the privilege of whiteness. You want to know why white folks used to try to fight with us? You want to know what they did? They made them overseers? So they thought they had some kind of position in sharecroppers, so they would no longer identify with black poor people.
You're responsible for divesting from the privilege you stand with today.
You're responsible for divesting from the privilege that you have today.
And you can stand there and smirk, we can take it from you. That's what y'all failing to realize. People of color, marginalized identities, we can take it from you. That's what y'all thinking. See, that's privilege. You think you untouchable. But that's what we need. The world is shifting. Y'all see it. That's why you're uncomfortable. That's why y'all coming together and you're voting. Because we got Trump running as president. You think white supremacy is okay. I got y'all. I'm reading y'all. And I'm still seeing. But what you don't understand, we're not uneducated anymore. We're at the fucking school. We have them now. Just a little bit, because we got access, we just haven't got equity. I never said we didn't have access. I said we didn't have justice, liberation, or equity. That's what I'm saying. He said, show people up. I can repeat it.
Don't dismiss them.
I don't care. I don't care about recording. That's what y'all don't understand. I'm trending motherfucking carpenter. I don't care about recordings. I don't care about your whiteness. And damn, one of y'all murky ass motherfucking intimidating me. You do care about your whiteness because you're trying to save it. But this group, these same faces shouldn't exist. And you guys are just also bothered by this whiteness is a goddamn term. The fuck?
What do you mean your skin color?
Blackness is a term. This is our blackness. Nigga, like, what the fuck you mean? I'm proud of my blackness. What the fuck you mean? I can't say whiteness. You said black.
You said black, plural.
That's what the hell you said.
Freedom.
Yeah.
Correct? Correct? I'm not wrong on that. Freedom of speech, correct.
Okay. I have something to say. It is not your space to say, it is not your right to say that safe spaces should not exist.
Delegitimizing everyone's identity. When you tell trans people where the fuck they can go or black people where they can go, that is delegitimizing. No, hold the fuck up. You're telling me I don't have the right. I don't have the right to be in your public space. Like, you're literally telling me, hey, this is your safe space and you feel safe here, but you don't have the right to feel safe there. So we're just gonna go ahead and get rid of that and bring you back to us judging you.
Define an intellectual safe space for me then. Because you know your definition, so go ahead and define it for me.
My intellectual safe space is the idea that you can't retreat from.
I'm not retreating. I'm making myself safe and comfortable.
That's fine.
You're living.
Exactly. That's perfectly fine.
Which they
if
have
I want this space, if I can have this space. It's my right to have this space.
When you go to class, who do you see around you? In history class, did it ever come up that you never saw anyone in history books like you? And the first time that there was, they were called a terrorist. They were called the first terrorists to come into this country. Who do you see around you in your classes? What do you see when you're walking? Who do you see when... Who do you see?
Name one trans person you know in history.
Other than me.
All you're telling us is that you don't want to be around us. That you don't like us. That we
I
know
invited you to my meeting.
Also, that they
no,
don't have opinion
to
know what's shut down.
No,
it's the
just,
same
if
thing
if
we had
on
the
you think you're going to correct him?
Yeah. Go ahead.
No, but this is something that is not true because three people asked to join our Facebook.
Were those people me?
No, but I didn't.
You know, so you did not invite me.
I wasn't invited either.
I was supposed to invite everyone.
Yes, because
yes, you're a student over.
No, sorry. Let me rephrase that. You're right.
Okay. Go ahead.
I'm supposed to extend personal invitations.
No.
I've been extending through Facebook, through social media, everything. And all three people who messaged me today who had the, what's the name of your event, Enough? Enough is their profile picture.
Yeah.
I sent them a personal message after they asked to join the club, said, I would like you to attend the meeting. So that's not true that I did not invite anyone.
Is it a private Facebook group?
No, it's a public one.
So there we deny.
Okay, so do you guys have anything else on your roster? Because I want to hear more of what you have to say.
And then also, can I suggest, just for a little more order and sake, that we do a hand-raising policy? So after you say your thing...
Actually, it's my meeting, but I will. I do like it.
Just,
I
wasn't trying to take over the meeting. I was just trying to let my voice be heard as a trans woman of color whose voice is not heard on this campus. That's what I was trying to do. It took me being assaulted on this campus by five motherfuckers and me posting it on Facebook, having 20,000 plus people watch it, having my mother, who's not supportive of my transition, send me a message, say, I'm sorry that you have to deal with this shit, but I need to get you mace so you can walk on this fucking campus. Having my grandma call me and tell me, I'm sorry that your university does not care about you. Or seeing that the center and that the OMA and that my school, College of Liberal Arts and Sciences, have released responses, but our university has not said shit. So it is not me trying to take over your meeting. It is me trying to get you to listen to the voices that you are excluding through this bullshit organization.
Did I not? Alright. If you're saying exclude and that I'm ignoring you, I told you at the start.
No.
I told you at the here.
That you saw my video. Yes. Everyone saw my video. I fucking get it. But what are you doing in support of my video? What are you doing to change the climate of this campus? What are you doing as a white person who has the privilege to walk into a classroom and be automatically respected because you were born with a dick? Because you are male, because you are a male presenting identifying person, you have that privilege that you can walk into a class and you are guaranteed to get respect from your professor because you are white. Are we going to have those conversations when we talk about there's no need for safe spaces on this campus? Because if you're not white, or if you're not part...
If you don't feel like you're being respected by a teacher, you should absolutely file...
I'm not being respected by the institution!
What institution?
The University of Kansas!
You can't say boogeyman. You have to identify something.
Where do you want me to start?
You go to this school. What do you mean boogeyman? You visit the school.
No.
We are here. We are here. We are here telling you. We are here telling you. That's why we came to your meeting. To tell you we are not safe. To tell you that what you're doing is breaking down all the work that we've ever tried to do to feel like we could live at this university. What you are doing here today is completely depleting all the safety that we've built up. You trying to get rid of safe spaces? Are you kidding me? Why do you fucking care? You don't even go to them. Why do you care?
You don't use them?
You
don't care.
About physical safe space. I'm talking about
regardless, safety
no,
should be afforded to everyone.
No,
period.
You don't believe in mental health.
I'm
just wondering. It seems like you don't. So do mental safe spaces not
need
to exist as much as physical safe spaces if
mental health is real? No,
okay.
Mental and intellectual are different things.
That's why I asked you to define what that means.
Yeah, can we get a clear definition?
Yes, and the rest of your meeting was
on the campus,
specifically about
tell me what you want in your request to dismantle intellectual safe spaces. Because that's meaningless is how you explain it.
Could you say that I was distracted by a couple
basically just define what an intellectual safe space is and why you want to dismantle that.
An intellectual safe space, for from what I've seen across college campuses and what I've read from across college campuses, is the idea that as soon as you're presented with something that makes you uncomfortable on an intellectual level, you don't have to accept it, and you can just retreat.
Define
an intellectual level also.
Pardon?
The minor?
Please define both discomfort and an intellectual
level.
Can
I say something real quick?
Sure.
When I don't know a word, you tell me to look it up because
but
you have
privilege regarding that
when
area.
When you don't know a word,
okay, but
you
can find those words.
I'm talking about
the
regarding this
I do not care. And if you can't look at me and tell I do not motherfucking care, you can't read body
language. I can hear you. That's fine.
I do
not question. I'll make the effort to tell you.
So I'm talking about at all.
Okay,
regarding this organization.
Not only just
so are you trying to tell me you're respecting
violence
and shut down? Because that's definitely what I'm
talking about. Like, hero,
I am calling you, and you can get it on video. I am calling you a white supremacist. The fact that you think it is your duty and job and entitlement to destroy the same space.
The
you keep saying intellectual. Do you know the difference between discomfort and trigger?
I don't really care about
that. You need to know because triggers is a physical reaction. So I'm sitting in the classroom. Am I being accosted, harassed, maybe even physically harmed by a certain community? And then I go into a classroom and a certain community member thinks they can stand up and say whatever they like, even if it's problematic or causing harm or violence? Your definition, working definition of violence is mine. No, violence causes harm. So have you stepped through the social justice 101 that only
other than the walkthrough?
No.
Have you said to the only other than the walkthrough?
First time back on campus.
8 months, and why is that?
Because I was interning in Washington.
Okay, so you left the university. So you got a sample.
I mean,
we need you in here. Some definitions need some explaining, but.
Hello, Mr. Quisenberg.
Hello.
Go ahead. Continue.
Are we being too loud?
I don't know.
Listen, we don't get policed by Quisenberry either.
Nope.
Nobody.
He doesn't
quit. So,
you
want to
do that? Really?
You wasn't trying to fail?
You want to do that?
No, I ran out of course, of course.
You keep saying you invited me here. You did it. I showed up on my own.
It's sorry. I like shut down those ideas. When they're, you know, express like subjective what you think about those ideas.
It's
and you start targeting everyone. That's why I'm
here. I didn't know
that. I
wanted
to
see if I had known that you were
violent. If you're like saying, go kill this person.
And I'm sure you wouldn't. We would have the same conversation. I still would end it that you were a white supremacist.
Build the wall.
Okay.
And I also made you.
That's violence against.
You called me black at the very beginning. You called us black. If you called me black, I called you a white supremacist. That's
not
an interpretation.
So, sorry. That's not an
interpretation.
You're
telling people that they don't have
to. We don't have natural
sovereignty.
It's not
like
you. We don't
have natural sovereignty. Okay, first of all, immigration.
We are on
an immigration
plan.
This was built on immigration. That's what America is. Right. This isn't about, like, the wall being built is by the country.
Well,
but here, no, I'm telling you, it's a problem. You know, before you're immigrant, I'm doing it. You're not American, you're an immigrant. Pre-welfare state immigration is a lot different from post-welfare state immigration. There's problems.
Okay, can I ask you, what is the violence? What do you not agree with? As far
we deserve benefits because you enslaved us for 400 years. It's called accommodation for the disenfranchised. Your ancestors, and you still reap the benefits. You still reap the privilege of the genocide of Native Americans and the slavery.
People are not illegal. People may
they're undocumented. They are not a money. That brings you.
You
still
call us guys.
Gender term.
Fucking microaggression.
People. That's why I'm here, so I can say illegal.
People.
Oh, that's fucking funny.
Anyway.
So we're all just shouting over each other now. Is it okay if we end the meeting now? We're having another meeting next Thursday.
We'll be here.
Okay. Will there be opportunity for us to speak? I have a question for you. Will there be opportunity for us to speak and be heard? You can set guidelines. No. You can set guidelines for the way the conversation goes. It's your meeting, run it however you want. But will there be opportunity for there to be speaking and listening? That is my question. No, because every time someone spoke, another person spoke over another person.
Immigrants from Mexico,
and it was
from California. When we sent our men to the war,
I encourage more people to listen more.
Do you know about that? Because I know history.
Okay.
Accurate history, okay. Not white.
So you want, I think that.
So you want us to do the labor again? That's what I'm getting from that.
No, I just said that I'll.
Yeah, you want to encourage your people to not speak as much, and you want me, of course, the trans woman of color on this campus, who made myself visible and at risk every fucking day to. Why are you gonna ask another? The key is don't do that. Well, no, it's because he's asking me to ask all of us to not be.
It's her pronoun.
Yeah, and if you watch my video, you would know that. That's a disrespectful of you. And ignorant as fuck.
I said he.
And he didn't
say it again. Because that's what people do when they have white privilege. Do not care.
And cis privilege.
Okay, guys, we're going to be meeting again next week on Thursday at 5 in the same alcove.
Cool.
If you would like to come back and keep talking, we can.
We shouldn't have to.
We'll be there. Don't worry.
You guys don't have to.
No, we'll show up. We'll show. We show. We do the work. That's the thing. We do it to save ourselves.
We will always be here.
Go ahead now.
Oh, so you want us to sit in silence while you do white supremacy?
I never said sit in silence. Can we have our meeting?
Well, and that.
Don't talk to me like that. Don't talk to me like that, and I won't respond correctly.
It's a simple question.
Don't clap your hands at her. That's a bad mistake. Yes, as long as you.
Because you're a white supremacist.
Okay, that's fine.
Okay, thank you.
It's not fine though.
It's fine for you because you benefit from the system. But you literally just said.
You are white supremacist. No, it's not. Let me get this clear real quick before I leave. It's not a disagreement of whether you're a white supremacist or not. If you believe in this snowflake bullshit, if you believe that there should not be safe spaces on this campus, if you believe that there is not institutional racism on this campus, that is you not recognizing your white privilege, the privilege that you have to walk on this campus, to walk into any store, to do anything. I have the same privilege. You're going
to
fucking tell me I have the same privilege. Because when you walk from fucking the Union anywhere, did you get stopped by anyone? No one catcalled you. No one said, show me that you're a real woman. Yes, you admitted that it was horrible, but what are you doing to change it? What are you doing? Are you telling your other cis friends, hey, don't treat trans women like shit? Hey, don't objectify women. Hey, let's get our heads out of our asses and for once listen clearly that people are fucking dying. Is that not clear? Do I need to post on your page every fucking day a different person who has died? Because if I have to fucking do that, I will, and you best fucking bet I will have a trigger warning on there, and then I will have a content warning, because those are important.
They're individuals. We don't believe in systematic oppression.
So are you going to keep saying illegals? Is that how you're going to refer to them?
Yes.
Okay, then tell me right now. Call me and you'll say illegal. I want you to tell me in my face.
You don't
make
you
it about me. Tell
you
me
don't
in
don't
my face
you
right
don't
now.
Know that she's an
illegal. Yeah. I can't say.
What?
I can't say.
Okay.
I'm so sorry.